So Jennifer, how did you decide to become an engineer?
I've always loved science and math, the technology avenues, and but I think more broadly, I've always gravitated to the idea that it was fulfilling and gratifying to work on something, to sort of work on problem solving in a way that you could go see that later.
Oh, yeah.
So there's a lot of other disciplines, even within engineering, but civil engineering in particular always interested me because, you know, you're helping build something,
right,
or redevelop something or design something that you could then go back later and, yeah, say, hey, I helped make that better.
Was it your brothers or your father? Was he sort of messing around with
models
and stuff?
My dad is actually a civil engineer also.
Oh, right.
But I don't feel like I grew up,
right,
wanting to do exactly what,
yeah,
my dad does. Okay. And he does his line of work is a little bit different, but it, right, makes for fun conversation.
Right, right. But so there was an influence there, I guess.
He was real excited when I decided to go to engineering school.
I bet. What projects that you've worked on are ones that we can... That we should know,
yeah,
about.
Or well, what? So one of the, my degree is in civil engineering, which in and of itself is a fairly broad field. Mm-hmm. Through some, we'll call it trial and error, I have figured out that transportation is really what interests me the most. And I think part of that came from a number of years working in Massachusetts on a series of projects that really focused on evaluating the safety of infrastructure as they related to children, mm-hmm, and schools, and how can we as engineers design projects that would go on to encourage children to walk and bike to school,
right,
in a safe way.
Right.
And as such, I got to visit something like 30 different communities and take a look at their infrastructure and then provide some design recommendations on how they could work to improve that. And the first time that any of those projects were, you know, the first one of those to be built was just really,
yeah,
it was,
yeah,
really exciting, particularly because of the kid aspect, I think.
Yeah.
You know, when you can help to provide a safer environment for someone to change that type of behaviors.
Yeah, yeah. One last thing. Do you have any advice for any women or young girls who are thinking of getting into engineering?
Yeah, call me.
All right.
Well, I would. It's a terrific field. Yeah. And actually, a shout out to Portland's Public Works Department in particular. You know, when I went to college, mm-hmm, definitely a male-dominated institution, and some,
yeah,
of my early jobs, there were a lot of men, but Portland employs a lot of female engineers and a,
right,
lot of females in public works, which just makes it for a great, diverse working,
yeah,
environment.
All right, everybody. That was Jennifer Ladd, Senior Transportation Engineer at the City of Portland. Thanks so much for watching. We will see you again soon.
All Things Bike is brought to you by FitWorks, Rider First Bike Fitting, Rider Matched Bike Sales. Locations in Peabody, Massachusetts, Waitsville, Vermont, and Ridgefield Park, New Jersey. And Frame and Wheel, eBay selling services for cyclists, bike shops, bike companies, and cycling-related nonprofit organizations. Time, space, cash, pick three. And AD Bikes, the modern face of Austro-Daimler cycling and the bike company of the future. Become bike. Become AD Bike.